The NHL forced the Oilers to trade Wayne Gretzky, and here is how they did it. So going back to 1988, Wayne Gretzky was coming off his fourth Stanley Cup in Edmonton. By this time, his career points was 664 goals, 1257 assists, 1921 points.
In how many games?
sorry, cut that out. Like, I had it in my Excel sheet, but I forgot that column. So he was 27. Okay.
Coming off his fourth cup.
Yeah, fourth cup. His final cup.
Wow.
In Edmonton. But after that fourth Stanley Cup, he was traded to LA right after that.
Yeah. All I remember from that is seeing Gretzky crying at the press conference. That's literally the only image I have.
Is that why you don't like Gretzky?
No, no, no.
You're like,
no,
oh,
no.
This is, he's another Crosby crybaby.
No.
So the story is that the Oilers owner was bankrupt. Mm. What the package was, basically, in a nutshell, it's 5 first rounders and $15 million in cash. And that $15 million in cash equals to $40 million today. Seems like a lot.
Right.
The guy owned the Oilers. He was about to get bankrupt. He had a lot of loans to pay. $40 million. Yeah, makes sense. Mm-hmm. So I did some digging.
Oh, I love it. Please, enlighten me.
So this guy's name was Pocklington. And basically, he had oil business in Alberta. And at one point, all his businesses in total sales combined was $2 billion.
Back then.
So now I'm thinking, okay, so this guy needed $40 million to, because he couldn't pay Wayne Gretzky? I found it very strange. But after that, apparently, he actually was going bankrupt. Even to this day, he owes like $80 million to the Alberta government.
All his businesses failed or something? Or he was just in debt in all of them, I guess?
When he was trading Gretzky, it was starting to fail. This is the guy that sold like Yari Curry, Mark Messier. Globe and Mail reported that he actually took in money from other places while he was selling the players to himself. It's a little shady. Mm-hmm. The point is that he did need the money.
Right.
It seems like. Okay. So maybe he needed $40 million. So he sold Gretzky to another owner in LA. And Gretzky's contract was $3.33 million for 9 years and a little bit ownership of the LA Kings. Mm. Doesn't sound too bad. Right. So who's this new guy? How rich is this guy? The LA owner. His name was McNally, but he was actually not that rich. Okay. And after 5 years after the Wayne Gretzky trade, Bank of America was going to sell the LA Kings team because the LA owner owed $90 million.
Wow. Okay.
It's like a guy that was going bankrupt sold this player that was going bankrupt.
Right.
It's a little weird, right? Mm-hmm. He pleaded guilty of 2 counts of bank fraud. Accounts of conspiracy and wire fraud, went to 70 months in jail, and still to this day owes bank money. And after 5 years after the Gretzky trade, he resigned from the Kings team. So he wasn't owner anymore.
Okay.
And then a few years after that, he left the Kings altogether. He also lied about going to Oxford, and he admitted to smuggling ancient artifacts into the United States.
From where?
So my theory is, now I'm questioning, okay, where did this guy get the money? Did he have the money? Because he still owes money today, right? So my theory is, what if the NHL paid the LA Kings owner so that he can buy Gretzky to move him to LA? So think about the benefits.
Right.
Exposure in non-traditional market. Increased TV viewership. Expansion and relocation potential. Merchandising and marketing.
Mm-hmm.
Youth participation.
Right.
Like Austin Matthews in Phoenix.
Right.
Impact on local communities. Anaheim, San Jose.
Right. I mean, California is just the hub.
Yeah.
Right?
It's today. It's bigger population than Canada, last time I checked. Not too sure because Canada is taking a lot of immigrants. Legacy and long-term impact. So those are the benefits, right? Well, originally I was thinking maybe the NHL forced the owner to make the trade.
Right.
But to me, it doesn't make sense. It's like, Chris, you're the owner of the Oilers. I want you to trade Gretzky.
Yeah.
No, you're not going to agree to that.
Right. Why would I?
So I'm thinking maybe the NHL kind of enticed with cash.
Right.
Because they knew he needed the money.
Right. And the LA owner didn't have it.
Well, he could have.
Could have.
But it seemed like he was on the downhill.
Right.
So the probability is that maybe he committed fraud with the bank and got the money, or the NHL kind of supplemented the money. So that's just the theory that I had, but it's kind of weak. I'll admit it's kind of weak just because there's no evidence of anything.
Right. It's all speculation.
Speculation.
It's all absolutely speculation.
I could totally see it happening. I wouldn't be surprised if we get more information in the future. But right now, there's no evidence of NHL giving money to LA Kings owner. I just thought it was very weird that a guy that was going bankrupt, that seemed like he had a lot of loans, because after 8 years, he went bankrupt, right?
Right?
So by then, he was buying Gretzky. He's probably had a lot of loans left.
Mm-hmm.
But he was still able to get $40 million back in the day, which kind of... And his portfolio was like nothing like the Edmonton Oilers owner. So,
yeah. I mean, hey, it makes sense, man. If they're willing to cover up Gretzky and talk its gambling ring, like they're gonna do whatever they can to get their superstar to LA. Like LA is Hollywood, you know what I mean? So
that's what I was thinking too.
Right?
It's like because they cover up so many stuff.
Right.
Sexual assaults, Wayne Gretzky gambling.
Right.
Although it's not proven, but it's kind of writings on the wall, you know.
I saw a great video last week, which gave some great evidence for it. So.
Yeah. So out of a 10, how convinced are you?
We'll have to come back to it.